Play to Learn Preschool. Hey, we're back after spring break. We hope you took some time to rest and recharge your batteries. We did.
Well, I don't know how much resting I did.
I did.
Jenny did. I did stuff around my house.
No.
I painted my deck and
not
stuff
me.
Like that. Jamie did.
I took the rest and recharge to heart. Spent the week on vacation. Anyway, hi everybody. We're glad to have you join us. We are back after spring break, like I said, and this month, so we did spring. We talked about spring and the change of the seasons right before we went on spring break. And now we have 2 weeks left in April. And so we are teaching our students all about Earth.
My favorite unit.
Stemma takes over for this one. We're spending some time this first week just talking about what Earth is and what kinds of things we find on Earth. And land and water, and then
next week we learn how to take care of our planet.
We'll do more of the reduce, reuse, recycle. Exciting.
Jamie's not a fan of that part.
It's not that I'm not a fan of reuse. You make me sound
no, awesome. not that part. Just some of the science experiments I do.
They're
she's
so
like,
gross.
Oh, that's disgusting. I'm like, well.
It's not that I'm not a fan of recycling.
She's a good recycler.
I recycle at my house. Mm-hmm. Anyway, hi everybody. We missed you too. Hey Pam. Hey Jenny. Hi everybody. We're glad to see you too. So we thought to just kind of get back into the routine here with Facebook Live that we would take some time to just show you around and let you see what we have set up for centers in our classroom this week. That's it.
Now Earth Day is on Saturday.
It is.
So if you are learning about the Earth or recycling, the environment, this is a really good month to do it.
April's a good month. Anytime's a good month.
But this is
a good month. Our kids are really interested in the planets, too. Mm. We've been doing a little bit of plant. We'll talk about that tomorrow when we share some circle time activities. But they've been really interested in the planets.
Yeah.
Okay. So usually, you know, we're really organized. Like, we're going to show you these five. And today we figured we would just kind of like walk you around the room. So we'll need
you a whole bunch. We have more than five. I was counting them.
We'll just kind of like show you around. If there's anything specific that you'd like to see, just leave it in the comments and I'll try to catch them as we're going. Our centers, like we always say, are about 2 hours each morning. The students are free to move at their own pace. They're free to choose their own centers. We, of course, invite them to do different ones and encourage them. But we feel like the burden is on us to make sure that the centers are distributed fairly so that if they only choose one or two centers, they get everything they need in terms of literacy and math and fine motor and all those other components at that center. So here goes.
Okay, this is our first one.
Here we have a math / sensory center.
Okay.
So I got these trays at the Target dollar spot.
Oh, that's right.
And they had beading, like wooden beads and
strings.
That's
a whole different Facebook Live video.
A different day. Mm-hmm. Don't start it on me. Jen was like, how many beading
ones? Remember the whole conversation with the pom-poms?
Anyway, we don't remember that. You're supposed to say, nope, we don't remember the pom-pom conversation.
Okay, so the trays are from the dollar spot in Target.
Yep. We fill them with some colored sand. You could do flour, sand, salt, sugar, whatever. And then these are plastic jewels. And what we did here is just printed some, they're going to be backwards until I flip the camera on, just some Earth. And we put numbers on them, but you could do letters. And I'll leave a link after we log off. I'll leave a link. You can just print these off of my Google Drive. And so we put these out as an invitation to play for our students. So they could either, I'm going to try to do it backwards so it looks right for you. It's not because the, anyway, they could either draw the number in the sand tray. They could count the number of beads to match the number
in the
sand tray. Four beads.
Number four.
They could draw the number four. It's going
to
be backwards.
Backwards and up, kind of we're upside down too. It's not really.
It's kind of like the story of our week after spring break. We're still a little backwards and upside down. Anyway, so they could make the number. Oh, that sort of worked. Anyway, it's just an invitation to play with numbers and some sensory materials. So it's sand, blue sand from the craft store. But you could use any sensory material. You could use rice or sand,
salt.
Flour works really well and doesn't make too much of a I mean, it does make a mess, but you can vacuum it up
pretty easily. All of this makes a mess, but that's why they like playing with it.
Yep. So this is our math center here at the yellow circle table. I'm going to switch the camera around to show you maybe the bulletin board.
If you want.
And the sensory table. And then we'll kind of do just a little walk around the rest of the classroom. So, okay, here goes. Okay, so let's do the sensory table first. So here at the sensory table this month in April, we actually have a non-food bin filler, and it feels really nice.
It does.
This is paper shreds from the pet store, actually. They have lots of different colors of paper bedding. It's low dust and just recycled paper. So we put, it is good that it's recycled. Blue, green, and white paper in there with some small globes and magnifying glasses, just as a sensory way for the students to experience the earth and just to investigate the earth. So we're just giving them some chances to look at the globe and talk about the blue water and the land. And because we've already learned about polar animals, they're also trying to find the North Pole and the South Pole. So, hi, thank you guys for joining us. Yay, if there's anything you want to see, just let me know. We're just kind of doing a quick center tour today. And then at our bulletin board over here, sometimes the bulletin board just displays artwork, and then sometimes we try to make it interactive. Or this month, we did
it's both.
We had it as the Humpty, not Humpty Dumpty.
Hickory Dickory Dock.
Hickory Dickory Dock. Right, last.
And when I took it down, I put the flowers up, and the kids say,
they were trying to take them off.
What are we supposed to do with this one? I said, oh, okay, then I'll make it interactive. So I cut out some clouds and put the numbers on there, and then cut out some raindrops out of felt, and then they just stick them on.
It's just white felt, and the blue raindrops are felt. And those number stickers,
Target. You can use
Target. You could just
paper, whatever you
or write them with a Sharpie. Pam, I'm not sure where I got the globes. I've had them forever. The filler in the sensory bin is paper bedding from the pet store.
It's for like guinea pigs or hamsters.
We'll recycle it after we're done playing with it. All right, so then over here at another table, we've been really trying to make sure that the students in our pre-K class are ready for kindergarten. And one of the things that we're still working on is scissor skills. So this is just an invitation to practice with scissors.
Someone's already done these
ones. I think they wanted to color them, which is why I saved them.
Okay.
Anyway, there
this
are.
Is
I did a really great job.
She did a really nice job
coloring. So the kids are just sitting here, and there's a bin of scissors and some markers, and their job is just to cut along the line. And like we said, our kids do get to choose which centers they go to, but we did have everybody come and do this one. I just invited them and we didn't have any opposition. So
there's a whole bunch of different ones.
And those are from our plant unit. I'll leave a link at the end, but cutting practice on a straight line is a really important thing before they get to kindergarten.
For sure.
We're also working on some shapes in terms of, I guess, another math center here at the magnetic board. So this one, we've got some trash cans with different shapes on them, circle, square, triangle, and rectangle. And then we printed pictures of different everyday objects. And then, Gemma, do you want to show on the back of those? We put a piece of that Xyron magnetic tape that I like to use on everything. And they are just supposed to sort the shapes. So put the trash in the right trash can, recycling bin, I guess. And I think there's six of each shape. They look like they're sorted pretty well right now. But the kids love to play the magnet board, and working on a vertical surface is a nice change for them from sorting things down on the tables. So that's a fun one. And then I guess we could show the art easel, because right above you, Gemma, you can see the kids each have an art spot there on the wall. And they've been painting the earth, of course, because we've been learning about the earth, and so a lot
they
of times
really well
they do that. I'll show you where that is. Oh, sorry. So over here on our art easel, we have some pictures, some maps, and then some pictures of the earth, just for them for some inspiration. And they don't have to, if they want a blank piece of paper that doesn't have a circle already drawn on it, of course we'll give that to them. But they've been really interested in painting the earth. So the paints that we put out this week are green, white, and blue. And again, like if they ask, like I really need red, of course we'll go get them a cup of red. or help them get that for themselves. So they've been painting the earth. I'm gonna pan again, sorry, that looks really awful when I do it, but you can see that the older kids are really doing an awesome job with that. So those are some of their paintings. You wonder how much the creativity costs. Not too much, we try to recycle. Oh, sorry, the camera's gonna catch up. Ah, all right, and then, let's see, over here at the light table, just another earth inspiration, a little invitation to play.
I'm not gonna turn it on because
no, it's really bright. So again, we just put another map, and then
what did you use for this?
I cut apart a plastic folder, but you don't have to, but we just put a map and they can try to make a picture of the earth with the blue, green, and white glass beads.
They can fill these little cups up if they want to.
They're just kind of playing with the beads. They were sorting them by color. They were counting how many beads fit in each jar. And then some of them were trying to make like a map with the glass beads. But the light table is one of their favorite centers. So we try to switch that up every week and give them different things to play with there. Easy enough. And what else? Like over here, again, we just have a lot of, I'll kind of back up so you can see. We just have a lot of small areas for them to play. So this is another, we're kind of math heavy this week, aren't we? Some weeks are like that, I guess. So this is just a counting activity. Hi, everybody. And
Jamie's got these cute little clips. Wait, did you get these from Target
too? I don't know. So, Lucy, I will tell you that we do not store everything well, but I will show you how we do it in just
a
second.
I try my best.
We try. We have a very tiny storage unit.
Okay, so the trick with these we've found over the years is that we want the kids to be able to check to make sure they've done it right. Now, I put these little tiny ones up because they're green, but I actually did a checking system with the big clips. So they put it, there's one earth, they put it on the number one, and they can flip it over and see if they're right, the little stars.
It's a little self-checking system.
To say, hey, I got it right.
So it's just a counting and number recognition activity with different recycling pictures or different earth pictures. So they count how many reusable bags are on there and then clip the number and flip it over to check to see if they're correct. So this is, those clothespins are really good for fine motor practice for that pincher grasp. And then they're just counting.
And if you don't have any of these little fancy green ones, you can just
use regular clothespins from the dollar store. So Lucy is asking how we store everything. We've done another video on that, but then up here on top of our, cabinets. I have these blue boxes and all of our thematic units are in those blue boxes. So we've done another couple videos about how we store things in those thematic boxes. And then we also have, a tiny, teeny tiny storage closet where we try to keep, again, everything boxed up, labeled, and then put in there. So a lot of things we reuse. Like you'll notice if you look back on any of our other center videos, that we use this blue sand and these green, jewel bead things for a lot of different themes and a lot of different activities. We reuse a lot of things in different ways. So, and then the books we store a little bit differently. We'll have to show. Yeah, we did one really early on.
Did we?
Mm-hmm, about how we store all of the thematic books. We actually don't have a ton of great books for Earth Day. Do you guys have any great Earth Day books? We went to the library to get some and they didn't have a ton.
There's really not very many. And the ones that are around are not very...
They're too hard for our threes and fours.
They're hard and they're not really that exciting.
We have a lot of nonfiction, like a lot of atlases and books about recycling and trees turned to paper.
But
not great storybooks. So we've still been reading a lot of spring with our kids, which is the nice thing about being in charge of your own classroom.
You can still add rain and weather elements to it. That's really important.
Absolutely. So
you can't stop playing with this.
Make your own. Sure what you're talking about. Make my own books.
She could do that.
Oh, come on. Pictures would look like a 3-year-old drew them. Todd Parr has a good Earth Day book. Oh, now see, I feel like I have that one.
It's called Earth, right?
No. Todd Parr is the one with like the kid drawing.
Yeah,
oh, I forgot about that one.
Is it? There's one called Earth by him. But I didn't think
Brittany thinks I could write my own books. You're crazy, Brittany. I could not do my own books. I'm afraid. Curious George plants a tree. Let's see. Keep them coming. We're going to have to
have some gardening type books.
We have a lot of plant. We can do plant books. That's a good idea. I need to look at that Todd Parr book because I don't think it's with our Earth Day. I think so. I know I do, but I think it's separate.
I have a Todd Parr one about underwear. I didn't think that was appropriate. for this unit.
I'll need to look. Thanks for the good advice. Kids could relate to that. Yeah, you don't want to see me drawing pictures for a book. Anyway, those are our ideas. We will share some more tomorrow. Little Critters Just Begun. I've got a lot of Little Critter Mercer Mayer books, but not that one.
Are you sure you haven't heard
I've never even heard that one. Oh, keep these ideas coming. Yeah. Oh, good. Yeah, we'll have to look for those.
Because we probably have some of these books, and maybe they're filed in a different part of our book filing system.
It's not a perfect system, clearly. Anyway, tomorrow we thought we would share some circle time ideas for you, because we've got some great, we have some really great circle time. The kids have been really excited, like I said, to learn about Earth, and we have some, Gemma's come up with some really great circle time activities. So we'll share those tomorrow, and then, oh, thanks. List of lovely recycling books. You are the awesome. I love that Jenny Evolution page. You guys are awesome. Oh, see? We should do our planning all together. Gem and I will pull out our plan book. You guys can hop on Facebook Live and give us some great ideas. Thank you, guys. Thanks for joining us for Facebook Live. We appreciate you, and we hope you have a great day playing and learning with your kids.
See you
next time. Bye, everybody.
Bye.